Hi everyone, I am Venkat. In this video, I will explain how to install Redis on Windows 10 and Azure. Part of the agenda, I will cover what is a Redis, what is the advantage of the Redis, where we can use that one, and how to install Redis in our local environment as well as on Azure. What are the various client tools you can use to check the Redis is working or not, and best practices you need to be considered while set up the Redis. Redis is an open source and in-memory data structure store used as a database and cache and message broker. So if I look into the below diagram regarding to the normal flow of the website access, if user is trying to access your website, so what will happen is the data you will get from the database, it may be SQL Server, it may be Oracle. So there is like some of the scenarios you might be implemented normal cache when there is a non-transactional data, that means the data updates will happen very rarely. Those data, instead of hitting to the actual the database, you will put it into the cache and you will reutilize that one. That's where you will reduce the traffic between your database to your website to improve the performance of your application. So if you go with the old way, mostly like many people, they might be used the cache. So what will happen is after deployment, like each, now we have the one instance, obviously the cache will be sit there only. And if you put more and more data, you can't obviously where the your instance is there, the same instance will be shared the RAM between the cache and your application. So if you increase the instance from one to two instances, each instance maintain their own cache. That way, the concept called another concept introduced, that is a distributed cache. That means instead of maintaining the cache at your instance, make it a separate. So separate instance there that is only dedicated for the cache. So even if you increase the number of instances, all will be shared the same the cache server. Redis also like similar kind of things. It is Redis is a distributed cache mechanism. And as I mentioned, the in-memory data store. So like as I mentioned, it will work as a database, not exactly database. So it is at a non-SQL kind of the database. And you can also use this one for the message broker. So now how the Redis will work? Redis will work like a key value pair concept. That means, you know, the hash table, right? You put this key, unique key, and there is the value. In the similar way, like the value you can put here, I mentioned in the PPT, data structures which supports part of the value. That is the strings you can put it, hashes, list sets, and shorted sets, bitmaps, and hyperlocks, and even streams also. You can put these kind of the data structures it will support. There are the other Redis also comes with the features like transactions and PubSub and keys with a limited time to live. I will show the last one, but PubSub and transactions I will try to be covered the another video along with ASP.NET Core. So okay, now coming to the next one, we will now directly jump on the installation of the Redis in our local. Now if you see, I have the three ways I put it. That one, the first one is the Microsoft Archive Redis and Menurai Redis, and third one is the Docker. I will go with this each method, and I will also explain the pros and cons of each one. You can go with any one for your solution after this. Okay, let's start with the Microsoft Archive Redis. So this is my VM. Okay, now just it doesn't have any Redis. So what I will do is I'm going with the Microsoft I'm going to the Microsoft Archive in the GitHub. We have so many are there. Just I'm finding, try to be find for the repository of the Redis. Now we got this one. I click on this one. So this link also I will provide in the description of this video. You can get it later on. So if I see here, we have so many releases are there. So just I'm going here, clicking on the releases. Now the what we have, the latest one is a 3.2 point 100. So I am trying to be installed this one version. This is the latest version we have. So for this one, these are the assets. So I am going with the MSI one, so that it automatically create the Windows service. That makes easy. So I'm clicking on this one. So it is a 64 bit. So I'm installing this one. So the very simple steps actually, just click on the next. So this is the path where it will be going to be installed. And add the Redis installation folder to the path environment variable also. You can click on this one so that you can run the command from anywhere. Okay, I'm clicking on this. And this is the default port 6279, 6379, sorry. And this is the firewall, that's fine. And you can also set, this is the default one. If you want to increase, you can increase that one. I'm going with the default one. I'm clicking on the install. Now, part of the installation, what will happen is it will put some files into the program files Redis, and it will also create a Windows service to run the server. Okay. Now, after completing this one, now indirectly I can say Redis is installation is completed. Let me check how it installed. So go to the C program files, and then if you search with Redis, you can find these files are there. So now here within these files, you have the two things are there. One is the Redis server, another one is the like CLI, indirectly client to test that one. This is the one. And second one is if you go to the services, I'm looking for the Redis. Now Redis is running. Now what I will do is I'm stopping this one. First I will show, I'm stopping this one. Now if I see, if I'm trying to be run, this is the Redis CLI is the client kind of thing. Okay, so now I'm going to be run this one. So see, could not connect to the Redis because it is looking for your local 127.0.0.1 means your local, and with the specific port, no connection could be made because the target machine actively refused it. So in the local machine, the Redis server is not running. If you look into here, this is the there is a Redis server, but it is not running. Now what we will make it, we will manually try to be run. Okay. Now Redis server is running at your local with this port of 6379. Okay. So if you see, the running mode is a standalone mode. Now I will try to be connect from my local. Now I am running this client one. Now if you see, previously it was given no connection, now it is connected. Now what I will check is keys stop. There is no keys. Now I can also, there is a commands are there. Those commands like you can find here. If you go with the Redis cache, if you go here, there is, this is the redis.io, and there is a documentation or commands are there. What here you can search with the, what I want to search is like I want to get and set first basic one. Okay. Yeah, this is the command actually I'm looking just for your showing here. This is the documentation is very good. You can check like, okay, how to set. If you see here, the commands are set key, you can give the key, but value will be in the double quotes. So I will go with the same way set, just so obviously you can also find the syntax here, the intelligence. Now I will give name, name is the key, and value will be the hello. Okay, now I am entering that one, so it is a okay. That means command executed correctly. If I want to check the keys, how many keys are there? Okay, already you can see previously nothing is there, now name is there. Now I want to get the value. So get, and key is the name. So I got the value. So in the similar way, now it is test, I tested, it is working fine. Now I'm closing here. The server is I manually open, right? I'm closing this one. Now let's check. So see, now it could not connect. So every time you can't come here and run the manually the server, right? That's where like part of the MSI installation, it also set up to run the Redis cache, like a server always try to be run via Windows service. So now if I see, I am starting this one. So if I see the path also, where it is pointing, you can see it is saying that one, the same path, Redis server.exe, and it is making the run. Okay. Now it is running now. Now if I see, I am not running manually this one, but I will try to be try to connect to the server. See. Now, because once you restart that one, you lost everything. Right? This is also you need to be make sure that one. Okay, now I am setting up. Okay, name, hello, and I will get the name, and there is a command called append. The name I'm giving the same key, but just I'm giving that one, it will append that one. So I am getting the name, so I got hello world. So now it is working. Now what you can see is we installed the Redis in our local, so both server and client I can able to see now. So if I want to check what is the version of this Redis, if you see here, you can also check here, but by the client I can check. So you can, if you type as an info, so it will give all the information. Okay, now if you see here, the Redis version 3.2.100. So even if I see the documentation now here, the same thing is given, the same version. Now what is the latest version of the Redis? This may be your another question. So if I coming here, so now we have, I'm clicking here. See, this is a stable version is a 6.0. There are the other versions are there where you can check that one. And even if you go with the some other, all the things are there, you have so many versions are there. You can see that one, but latest version you can say is a 6.0. Okay. Now, if we use this Microsoft Archive, this is the maximum version you can download. If I want to be go with the four like other versions like a 4.0 or I think what is the last one is the, if you see the 5.0, you can't do that one. Okay, that's why if you go and see here, if I go and see the code, this one, they clearly specified this project is no longer being actively maintained because this open source is some group is made, they are not maintaining that one. So this is the last version you will get it. If you are looking for a Windows version of the Redis, you may want to check out the Memurai. So that is the what like I'm going to be, I specified here, the second one is that one. So let's go with this one. Memurai. This is a third party one. I can go with the free one. So if I specified here, the pre version has the, what are the things are there, as I said, like PubSub, it supports that one. And it also have the something like you can, there is a difference. There is a price enterprise model also there. You can contact them. Okay. Now just I'm going with the default one. The only one point you need to remember is, if you install this one, it will works like a free kind of thing. If I want to go with this one, Memurai, like you need to be restrictions. There is a restriction. Only one restriction is restart required after 10 days. This is only, but it is also free. Just you need to make sure a restart is required after 10 days. Okay. Now I'm downloading this one. Now what I can do is just I am deleting these all. Otherwise in system has the both. So what I will do is I am trying to be delete the existing one. So by running the download before installing the Memurai, first I am the same installation. Just I am clicking the next. Instead of installation, I am removing this one. Okay. Now what you can see is like, just if you try to be refresh, this service should go. So if I see there is no Redis, it removed everything. And let me check the C program files. So nothing is there. It is also removed that one. Good. Now I am trying to be, now my local doesn't have any Redis. Now I am going to be install this one. So it will be installed in the memory folder. Previous one it installed in the Redis folder. You can change if you want, that's fine. And it's same thing, okay. Now it, you can also give the same port is there, go with that one, and I'm installing now. So now the where it was there, just I'm checking the first the physical one, instead of Redis memory. So we have these files are there. So now if you see this one, we have memory CLI is there, and but I can't see any server here. This like because this may be the server. Okay, let's check here. Did it install anything the regarding to the Redis or with the yeah. So the name is the instead of Redis, it is the memory. Even if you check here, yeah, I think this is the server, but they put the name as the memory. If you see this one, this is the server, and another one is the client. Now it is starting running now. So now if I click on the client here, there is a client, right? I'm clicking on this one, just checking whether server is running keys. Okay. Now I'm setting the name. Okay. And get name. I got this one. Okay. Now just I'm appending to make sure. So it is working fine. Now we will check the version of the Redis which comes with the memory. I'm going back to the CLI, checking by executing the command info. If you see here, the Redis version is the 5.0.9, which is the previous version of the current stable version. Current stable version, you know, like 6.0. Now this is the previous version. I'm not sure like whether you can get it the latest version, just you can check with that one. But if you see here, now the free version like intended to for development and testing, like only one restriction is you required to restart after 10 days. If you want to go with for enterprise, like there is no restrictions, you can have a look this one. The final way is the Docker. Don't feel that one I don't know the Docker and it is very difficult to configure, but I will show very easy steps to install the Docker and create the container for the Redis. For this Docker, what we need to do is, first of all, you need to be install the Docker, then you need to be create a container for the Redis. Okay, these are the steps you need to be execute, like to check the Docker. It is just like command, like Docker space version, and if I want to be know the images, like Docker space images, and if you want to pull specific image from the server, pull Redis to local. And these are the other steps I will provide in the description of the video. Let's start with the Docker now. So now just I am typing as a Docker. So if you see here, before that I will show that one I doesn't have Docker. Like okay, now go to the, I'm going with the PowerShell. Here I'm executing the Docker command. So it is saying that one, it is not recognized. So there is no Docker in the local. Once you type the Docker, the Docker will come. And if you go with this one, now this is the Docker website. I'm clicking on get started. So if you see here, so this is the Docker hub, and this is the Docker for desktop. I'm going with this one, like download for the Windows. Yeah, Docker install downloaded successfully. Now I'm going to be install the Docker. Now this is also one of the important point in the Docker installation, that is the enable Hyper-V Windows feature. Okay, just I am by default it is checked that one. Now it is downloading all the required packages which are required for the Docker. Let's wait for that. Okay, now the installation succeeded. It is asking we need to restart the machine. Okay, I'm clicking on this. Okay, I re-log in successfully. Now the if you see this one on the desktop, you can find the Docker desktop. Now let's click on that. So it will start the Docker. If you see here the icon, the desktop is, if you see that pop up started successfully.
successfully. Okay, now let's we see. Not it started, it is starting. While Docker is starting, it throws the exception. The exception is related to this virtual machine management service failed. The what was the reason for this one is the based on the Hyper-V component is not running. So I looked into the issue that to save the time, just I'm opening the the Docker for Win. This is one of the issue they mentioned here, and they gave the solution for this one also in the GitHub. Let me see the solution. They said like how to reproduce this behavior, and if I go down, they gave the various problems, what are the different ways to resolve this one. They gave the clearly the solution for various scenarios. So in my case, like what if you see here, I am using like the virtual machine, Azure virtual machine. So the problem is like if it's, they also clearly if you are using the Azure virtual machine, because I'm using Azure Windows 10 VM. So this is the solution here. I'm going here. If you look into this one, it is clearly saying the issue is your virtual machine should be like V3 sized. So what does it mean is like if I go back here, this is my virtual machine I created with my personal account. If I look into the size, so currently I am using this one, whatever I highlighted that. Okay, but it is not, see, V3 means this one. This is the type of the one you need to be take it. Okay, so if I see, this is the 250 costly, but like I'm taking this one for the demo. Okay, I'm selecting this and resizing. So resize of virtual machine is done. So like just I am reiterating this one. What do they mean is the V3. Like if you see here, you can take it any of these role. With various prices are there, you can take it any of these role. At present, I took D4S V3. Okay, now I'm reconnecting to the virtual machine. So now after resizing, I logged into my VM. I am clicking again to run the Docker in my local. So if you see here, now my Docker, the issue is resolved. Now Docker desktop is running. If you see, open the PowerShell and start hacking with the Docker or Compose. So now this is the Docker window. Now what I will do is, if you see here, like, okay, just I'm skipping this tutorial. If you see, there is no containers. Now we will start the Redis container. For this, like, I'm opening the PowerShell. Okay, now just I'm checking, like, to check the version of the Docker command and version, if you give that one. So now it is giving the version. Now the Docker is installed. Like that's why it is giving. Now what I will do is, I will check the images. Try to give all small letters. Okay. Sorry. See, like the command is executed. If you see this one, there is no images here. Okay. Now what I will do is, I will try to be pull the Redis image. Our Redis image is downloaded. Now if I try to be look into the, if I execute the image command, I can see the Redis in the repository. Now what I will do is, I will create the container. Okay, like two containers, Docker run, and we can give the name of the container. So I will give the my Redis, and you can give the port number. So just I will give 6379, that is the default one, and 6379, and the image name Redis. If you see this one, this whatever it is there on the right hand side, that is the within the container port, and left hand side is the of your local one to like map to the container one. You can give this one to the anything, like I am giving this one as a 777 just for your clarity. Now I am running this command. So just click on the allow access. Now the container is created and it is running. You can also check here the dashboard of the Docker. If you see, the container is running. To check quickly, like if I click on the CLI, that means it will try to be connect to the container. I am going to be execute the command of the CLI inside the container. So it is connected. Now you can see key star, it is working fine. Now this way, what I done now is using the Docker, like I created the Redis container. Now if you want to check the information, like to check the what is the version of the Redis, if you see here, the Redis version is the latest version. So this way, the Docker contains like so many versions. If you look into the Docker images, Docker Redis images, if you see here, these are the supported images are there. You have the latest one, previous version, and all other versions also there. So it is very easy like to spin new instance, or that means new container for the Docker. Okay, now we will jump on the next one.
Now we can move to the tools. These tools are the, you can use as a client tools. The once Redis server is available, you can test the server health, how many number of keys are there. You can easily navigate the Redis server using these tools. Let's start with the Redis desktop. And but this one is the 14 days free trial only. Like you need to buy this one. This is the commercial one. Let's try to install and see. Okay, now I will go to the Redis desktop manager. And if you click on the prices here, you can see this is what like we will be going to install the free version. If I want, you can go for the enterprise version. So I'm clicking on this one. Just it will, you need to be enter the details. So I already have an account, so that's why I will try to be log in that one. So once you log in, like you can download the Windows version. So Redis desktop manager is downloaded. Now we are going to be install this one. So just I'm clicking the next, agree, and it will be going to install in this path. So installation completed successfully. Now this is, you can see the icon on the desktop. I'm clicking on that. So you need to be login with your username password what you used previously. Just I'm logging with my active username password. So now I logged in. You can see this one till trial is active until the next month 6th. Okay, now I'm trying to be access this one. So just I'm giving the any connection name as like testing test one. Okay, test one, and this is my local. So first of all, I will try to be connect to my, like there are the two servers are there in this one. One is the server is this one, like Memrai. Another one is the Redis one. So first I am trying to be connect with the Memrai. Okay, now so this one, this is the port. Okay, and just I am clicking on okay, it is connected. Now if I see, there is no key value here. Okay, and I will try to be connect the another server, that is the Docker one, Docker Redis. Okay, but that is the local port is 777. So if I see this one, it has the two keys. Okay, now if I can also show that one. So if you have this port is a 777, that's why I connected here this one. That is the advantage, because now like with the 6379, I have the Memrai, the Redis is working on this one that has the previous version of 5.0.9. This is the Docker is the latest version, 6.0.6 something. Now you can see using this tool is very useful. Like you can see the value here, what is the original value here, and you can, if you want, I think so many operations you can do with this tool. Actually this tool is very handy, and this is the one tool. And the second tool, if you want to go through in detail of this tool, like I think you can go through that one parallelly. Okay, this is the one tool. Now The second tool I will be going to be explain is the Redis Insights. Okay, now let's move to that one. Okay, if I go for the Redis one, and so if I go for the support of this Redis, actually, this is the Redis Lab is the main major official sponsor for the Redis. So we go to the Redis Lab. So this one has the, if you go to the platforms, and there is a like a Redis Insights. So Redis Insight is a product of the Redis Labs. Okay. Now I'm going to be download this one. So you need to be just fill this one like the form. Okay. How just I will try to be. So the only one point here is like you need to be given the business email ID. Then only it will allow to download that one. Now I downloading now. Now I'm trying to be install this one. Okay, it is also similar like the previous tool. Okay, it will be going to install at this path. Okay, I'm going with all the default options. Installation completed. So if I go to the desktop, I can see Redis Insight. So I'm opening this. So now if you observe this one, this is the server started, Redis Insights. It will open with the port number 001. Okay. Now just I will say I agree everything and okay, terms and I confirm that one. So then it looks like this one because you're able to be accessed via browser. The previous one is this one is a like Windows kind of thing. This is the browser. So now I will be going to be add the database. Okay, add the same thing. You can go and give the names. Okay, for this one also I'm giving the test one. My local one is 0.0.1, okay, 0.1 and 6379. I'm going to be connect to my local first memory one, add the database. So now I can see this one. Okay, now I can also go and add to the other version. This is the Docker Redis one. This is also same 0.0.1. This is the 777 port. Okay. Now you can see this one here. So just I'm going to this one. You can see here the number of keys are there. How many active clients are connected? You can see like very good detail. For example, if I want to see the keys one, you can also see. Okay, this is the browser. If you see the keys, the what is the value of that one? Okay, you can change the value here one. Okay, I change the value of the key one. Even you can come and see here this one. So like you can see the value change here. So this is like the tools are very good actually, like for even the CLI also you can connect and you can set here. You can set like for example company as a key and this is a that will give as a Redis one something. If you execute, this is executed. Now you can go and see here, try to be refresh. So the company is there. So like particularly this Redis Insights also very good, but I think I can recommend you can go with this one instead of the Redis Desktop Manager because it is a only trial for 15 days. You can use this one, but only one restriction for this one is like it is has the I think only with this Redis Insights is it is up to 30 MB of the storage is the free. If I want to go beyond that one, it will be cost. So I think we can't in the local testing, it is more than enough for us. Okay, these are the two tools you can go with that one. Now local setup we saw like three ways and different tools we explained that one. Now we will jump on the Azure, like how you can create Redis on the Azure. So if I look into that one, this is my local account of my personal account of the Azure. So you can go and search it here as a Redis. So you have the Azure cache for Redis. Okay. If I click on this one, then I'm going to be create now. Now it is open. We enter the DNS name like. And resource group name you can give the existing one. Okay, Redis group. Okay, and I can give Australia East. Okay, 1 GB one, and you have the different plans. I am going with the standard one, and you can just I'm creating now. Yeah, Redis is created successfully on Azure. Now this is this one. Now if you check the version, like once we go to this one, the whatever the Redis name, and there is a in the overview view we have the console. If you click on here, it will directly connect to the Redis CLI. So if you type as a key start, so it doesn't have anything. You can set the name the same follow and get the name. It works fine. Then you want to know the information. So if you see the version, the Redis version is a 4.0.14. This is a version available on the Azure. You can't go 5.0 or 6.0. I think I previously showed that you can follow up the Azure updates regarding to the Redis. So better you maintain when you are working on the project on the server, you want to be go with this. This is a maximum. Then locally also try to be configured with this version. Okay, now I'm trying to be connect this one with the like from your client tools. So for this one, you go here and you click on the keys here. Okay, if I click on this one, you will get the primary connection. If it is from the you can directly give this as a connection string when you are connecting from the ASP.NET from the other applications. If you are using the client tools to check, okay, just I'm pasting this one. So like app insights, okay, not Redis insights. If I go with the Redis insights, so I opened the Redis insights tool. So just I'm clicking on the add database. Then just I'm giving the Azure Redis. I can give any name, and the host name will be the from the connection. This is the host name, and the port name is you can find here. It is not like a 6379 6380, and the username I'm not giving the, but password I am giving. This is the password. Okay, and I'm use the TLS. I'm ticking this one and click on add Redis. Now it is added. Now you can go here, you can check total keys are here. For example, now I am moving back to the console. I'm setting one more name like a test, and value is Redis something. Now this is one more key. If you come here and you can see here automatically it is refreshing. Two keys are there. You want to check what are the keys are there, like you can click on the browse, you can see what is the value. So this way, like you can use these tools and you can check what is happening at the Azure level, local level, these are all. Yeah, our next topic is the best practices. What are the best practices you need to be considered and follow while set up the Redis one? So I provided the link here. I will give the same these links into the description section. So if I move it to here, the best practice from the Redis for the Redis. The best practices for Azure Cache for Redis. These are all the, I think you can go through these all, but at some of the points I will say better we go with the standard. Because the C1C, like if you go with the below versions, means like those are all only okay for the dev and test. Like if I want to go for exactly for the production one, you have to be go with the standard or premium. That is the one you need to be considered. And like sometimes even you remember like it is an in-memory data store. So like there is a chance of the data loss can occur. Okay, to address this one, like they provided this article and try to be go with this one, like how the expirations will work that one. And next one is the like to improve the like performance, you can go with the max memory reserved settings. And if I go with the like this is also they gave the Redis works very good with the smaller values. If you have the put the larger value, like the performance will degrade. So try to be split it into the smaller chunks, try to put it into that one. And one more the best practices is like if you try to be put your application where your application is running in the same region, try to be create the Redis also and reuse the connections and that is a one, and at least like 15 seconds the timeout connection strings. Like you can go with these role and the TSL encryption also. Like already it supports 1.0, 1.1, 1.2. Currently 1.1, 1.0 are going to be deprecated. So better we go with 1.2. And ideal timeout by default, like something 11, 10 minutes are there. Like you can try to be set less than that. Memory management, they gave some good practices, try to be go with this URL. I will provide part of the description. And the couple of the links I given, that one is another one is check Azure Redis updates. I think if you go with here, the Azure update, just I'm searching with the Redis one. So if I see, you can see the links here, description, like what are the features are coming in the May 12th, something like enterprise feature coming to the specific region, something. If you see here, a new feature will be soon be available for the Azure CASE for Redis through a collaboration with the Redis Labs. Okay, so whatever you can see in the Redis, in the Azure, they are by collaborating the Redis Labs, it will come that one, you know. And if you try to see the, if you see on the August 2019, the 4.9 was there. So now these are the Redis updates in the Azure, you can go with that one. And next one is, there is a like available cache service in the Azure. Like you may be think that one, what are the different types of the cache mechanism Azure can support? If you see this URL, so previously, before introducing the Redis cache, like in the Azure, previously there are two are there. One is the Redis Azure Managed Cache Service that built on AppFabric cache, and in-role cache that is also built on AppFabric cache. These two are deprecated already. So in the Azure, if I want to go for any like a distributed cache, only Azure Redis cache only available now. That is the one point I want to be clarified. Okay, thanks for watching.